Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm Will, and we are back with, well, we're starting. Oh shoot, Batman, Arkham Knight. And sorry about getting on pretty late for the weekend. I'm almost at my normal stream time during the week. I have not been feeling great all day, so I honestly don't know how long today's stream is going to be. Hopefully, we could just do the full two. But, yeah, not feeling the best today, so we'll see. But yeah, we're hopping back into this. Well, back into the Batman series, I mean. And, yeah, I have not played this since... I think I got this and played it right when the DLC for this game came out. So that's, like, already, like, quite a few years ago. So let's hop into this. Normal subtitles on. WB being fucking weird about, you want to log into our thing? It's like, really, WB? How many games do you put out? Alright. Let's start a new story. Copyright. I've got you. Massive copyright claim. Under my skin. I've got you. A really big copyright strike. That's what they got me. Alright. I don't need the fucking Rat Pack coming after me. I've got you. Sacrifice anything, come what crap. For the sake of having you near. All right, I skipped through the options. I might have been too hasty, and I might have jumped something that was for like copyright music. I did not think this game would have copyright music. I would assume it would all be just, you know, original music for it. Wake up to, well, fuck me, right? Awesome. Actually, I have to move controls to keep it fiery.
This is how it happened. This is how the Batman died.
He dies like every few years, like it's fine.
Nine months ago, Joker was cremated. I pressed the button and burnt the evil bastard myself. And then we waited. Gotham braced itself for the inevitable power struggle. But it didn't come. Crime actually fell. Deep down, I knew war was coming. I was just waiting for someone to pull the trigger.
Love the design of the city in this game, what I remember. And this is super fucking weird. Choosing to do first person.
Thanks.
No problem.
The Adams is missing.
Thanks, honey. So, what'll it be? Your usual?
Sure.
Okay, chicken salad with no dressing.
No, you know what? Make it waffles. With a side of bacon. Don't tell my wife.
Whatever you say, officer. Oh, and if you want some more coffee, just shout.
Ah!
Next service, waffles with bacon on the side.
Hey, I'm sorry to interrupt your dinner, Officer, Owens. But there's a guy smoking over there in the corner booth.
That's not illegal, dillhole.
I'll have a word.
Or actually, is it? That could be illegal. I thought that was just more of a, you know, the restaurant itself chooses. Sir, stop smoking.
Excuse me, sir. There's no smoking in here.
Well, this is reality now.
Used just 5 ounces of my latest toxin. Tomorrow, this will seem like child's play. Gotham, this is your only warning.
You know, I'm not super up to date to all of Batman's stories, but honestly, I can't really think of any Batman comics where it's like Scarecrow's the main, like, big bad. And it's like weird that the movies and video games give him more urgency than I think I've ever seen him have in any of the comics.
Scarecrow's threat worked. Yesterday there were 6.3 million people in Gotham City. Today, not so many. The only people left on the streets are the sort that enjoy the chaos.
Gotham's finest.
Scum. Criminals. And worse. Not enough good people left to stop them.
And when he says stop, he means stand by and film it all with their phone. He's apparently documenting it, then stopping it is vastly more important.
It took just 24 hours for us to lose control of the city. Tonight, Gotham's relying on one man to save us all.
Yeah, I really love the city in this game, from what I remember.
We had a toy shop before we leave. Told my kid I was gonna buy him a present.
You can already do all the advanced stuff in this game that you couldn't do in a city from the bat. From the top. From the bat. Oh my god. Oh, that was a Freudian situation there. Alright. Batman. I am here.
I'm just glad you made it out okay. Sorry, I've gotta go. Stay safe, Barbara.
You still know how to make an entrance.
How's the evacuation going?
Last bus crossed the city limits an hour ago. I'm just glad my little girl got out when she did. Now the real work begins.
Any lead on Scarecrow?
We were tracking an unknown military vehicle speeding through Chinatown. It's the only lead we've had all night, but they gave us the slip. With the evacuation, I just don't have the manpower left in the city.
If you find it, tell your men not to engage. I'll deal with it.
Do you really think Scarecrow's crazy enough to detonate a chemical weapon in Gotham?
I won't let that happen, Jim. In case you need to reach me, it's going to be a long night.
All units, we've got a 1033 in Sector 2. Missing patrol car. Unit 247. Suspected officer down.
Hey, Batman.
Some might say it's going to be a long, not a Halloween type situation.
Oracle, I need the location of Unit 247.
Already working on it. How's my dad doing?
He's holding up.
Somehow, he always does. Okay, I'm sending through the squad car's location. Be careful. It's not looking good out there.
It's like he looks over. It's like Gordon looks over. It's like, Batman, what are you doing? Is that my daughter? What the fuck? It's like, why do you need a screen on it? Remember there being those floaty things. Ivy and Scarecrow. Two characters you don't really think about ever interacting. Shit. That was the wrong button. Oh my god, I hooked like so far away. I need to slam.
Hey, when's it my turn?
Never. Strike, strike. Whoa. Fighting is a lot more smoother here just because it's a lot simpler to take down foes.
Batman, I could use some help here.
I feel like in the other games, obviously the fights were way longer because
you're safe.
Thanks, Batman.
Had to do a lot more comboing.
Thought they were gonna kill me.
For example. Here, let me lightly hold your shoulder and then we can fly up 16 stories.
We don't stand a chance.
Stay here. I'll send someone to pick you up.
What are you doing?
Evening the odds.
It's like he does that same maneuver and he rockets off and the person's just like not there. It's like, what happened? It's like, you tried to grab me by my shoulder, you dick. Who does that? You see, just go whoop, flip right off.
They get their hands on military hardware.
This is probably my least favorite part of the game. Is the reliance on Batmobile. I think it's cool that it's in the game, but how much they use it. I think that's what most people's complaint in this game is.
Oracle, I need to track that military vehicle.
A squad car has picked up the pursuit. I'm relaying its location now.
And yeah, they really shovel in like a lot of the tutorial pretty quickly.
Call off your men, Jim.
Go Oscar 5.
Although it does control very well.
I'm calling off the pursuit. It's too dangerous.
Sir, we're right here. We can take these bastards. What the? They just fired an RPG at us. Who the hell
Oh!
5-6, pull back now. That's an order. Let Batman deal with this.
5-6 has taken a direct hit from an RPG. You're gone, sir.
Tim, please, Batman, you've got to stop him.
Don't worry, Tim. He's mine. That takes care of the vehicle. I need to interrogate the driver and find out what he knows. Where's Scarecrow?
Go to hell!
Are you fucking kidding me? You know how long I've been doing this.
Where is he?
I got nothing to say to you, Batman.
Talk, or I'll crush every bone in your body.
Okay, okay. He's working out of a penthouse in Chinatown. I swear that's all I know.
If you're lying, I'll break the other one.
The other one?
Oracle, check the chemical analysis I've just uploaded.
Sure. Is this what I think it is?
Scarecrow's new toxin. An uncontaminated sample.
You're not kidding. I'll prepare a full chemical breakdown on the back computer. What are you going to do?
Scarecrow's got a safe house nearby. I'm going to pay him a visit.
Let's hope this is the break we've been waiting for.
It's like the guy on the ground's like, who the fuck is that? Alright.
Control, looks like we got a body. Rooftop of the Gotham Herald. Falcon 4 out.
God, I can't even...
This is the place. I should check the penthouse on the
crap.
Floor.
What is the brakes? Agile in this game, it's insane. It definitely helps that all the enemies are super easy. I wanted to gong.
Well, that's made things a little more interesting.
Sir, it's Batman. He's here.
Were you expecting to find me, Batman? I'm afraid I must disappoint you. Take a look at the chamber. I want you to know the fear that is coming.
Listen up, Bat Freak. We're walking out of here, nice and slow. You try anything stupid, I'll blow her brains out.
Charming. But only one of us is getting out of this cell.
No! No! No!
Nothing like a little natural immunity.
What are you doing here?
Why did Scarecrow lock you up?
No, hello.
Tell me.
And what if I don't want to?
Then I burn every plant in Gotham.
Make it even more of a shithole.
What meeting?
Everyone was there. Penguin, Two-Face, Riddler, even poor Harley. Scarecrow said he had a plan. That together we could take you out, and Gotham would be ours.
Over my dead body.
I believe that was the idea. I told him that I wasn't interested in his pathetic human games. And when I came to, I was locked up in that room. It's such a shame that his vile toxin has no effect on me. Nature always wins.
Just seen that coming.
Will he ever learn?
You're coming with me.
You only had to ask. What's wrong?
But it gotta be tanks. Pretty fast moving tanks. I don't know how fast a tank moves, but that's pretty fast.
Go. We've got the target, sir. He's cornered. Don't move.
Are you sure it's him?
Confirmed, it's Batman.
Sir, that tank they have backing them up is unmanned.
Good.
I thought this would be tough. Well, it...
Yeah, I'm kind of surprised the,
60mm cannon operational. Riot suppressor engaged.
You fucking vaporized it. Dude, can you even imagine how amazing this game would look if it was made?
I've spotted six more unmanned tanks moving to China.
Unreal 5.
They'll be there any second.
I believe that's the newest one. I always forget what the name of the newest Unreal Engine is. Wait, what are we trying to do? Oh, there we go. This feels like a completely different kind of game. What is this fucking Blaster Master over here? Which I've only played the first that was on the original PlayStation briefly.
Activate the Batmobile weapon diagnostics. It's time to go to war.
Kinda lame that... Yeah. Like, I'm happy that there's a Gotham Knights game, which we are gonna be playing after this. Which I'm actually super excited about because I know nothing about that game other than, you know, you play as like the sidekicky characters. But man, it's lame that one of the next games that are coming out is that fucking lame-ass looking Suicide Squad game.
Simulation activated. Weapon energy system diagnostic test online. Stage 1. Destroy targets to charge up weapon energy and activate missile barrage.
You know, video game shit. Oh, this has got like a weird level of sensitivity to it. Hello? I just hit...
Missile barrage level 1, ready. Diagnostic stage complete. Stage 2. Charge the missile barrage to level 2 to destroy up to 4 targets at once.
This is dumb. They could have just had us charge it all the way up, have like three, so we can do a level one and then a level four. For some reason, I can't get used to...
Missile barrage level 2, ready. Diagnostic stage complete. Stage 3. Taking damage depletes weapon energy. Charge up missile barrage to level 2 and destroy 4 active targets to complete diagnostic test.
Yeah, I forgot how much tank battle simulator this is. Although it feels good for the most part. But it, honestly, it just makes me kind of want to play Armored Core 6. That.
Missile barrage level 2 ready. Diagnostic test complete. Simulation complete. Batman, I'm seeing transport deploying more tanks at Panessa Studios. I've warned GCPD to pull their men off the streets.
I'm heading there now.
Come in, all
nope, you. That's for exit. I'm trying to figure out what the fuck break is. Oh, goddamn, break right there.
Back to GCPD. We're not equipped to deal with what's out there. Thank God there's someone who is.
It is not. Alright, there we go. Okay. I'm an idiot. I should look down in the corner. For some reason, I just think it's triggers. How the fuck did they get so many tanks into this goddamn city and nobody noticed? Wait, whoa, what was that? Well, wait, what the fuck is going on? Target. This shit is going on here. Okay, that was a lot more sloppier than I thought.
Jim, tell your men they can resume their patrols. The tanks have been dealt with.
Thank God. Let's hope they were the last.
Don't count on it. I need the isolation chamber prepped at the GCPD lockup. I'm bringing in Ivy.
AR challenge reveals.
I've created a series of diagnostic simulations to test the various functions of the suit and Batmobile. Simply select the appropriate program, and the Batcomputer will provide a navigational marker.
Thank you, Alfred. Oh, ah, damn it. I keep on accidentally hitting the trigger, the left trigger. I thought you could just run into people and they just get tased and flung off.
Good to have you here, Batman. Bring her down to the lockup on the lower level.
It's like, what am I, a cop? They definitely upgraded their police station from the one in City.
What the hell? Hold your fire! It's Batman!
It's Batman's tank, don't worry.
Any progress with the fear toxin analysis?
It's gonna take a little while longer.
Drop by the clock tower when you're ready, and I'll show you what I've got so far.
Who taught you to drive?
It just made me think of Alfred teaching him how to drive a tank.
Scarecrow's gonna break you, Batman.
Get fucked.
Honestly, why do you even bother with these meat sacks?
Civil unrest? There's a war on the streets. We don't have the manpower or the equipment.
Well, look who it is.
Ivy. Well, that's one less thing to worry about.
Is the isolation chamber ready?
Glad you're putting it to good use.
You old son of a bitch.
Oh, good. Another cell.
I don't know what Poison Ivy's current status is in the comics, but I've said this before. It's like her and Mr. Freeze. It's always blown my mind that, like, I don't know, they didn't get into some sort of, like, program for rehabilitation where it's like they end up helping Gotham. Where it's like, okay, you're a botanist, you control plants. How about you help us become more eco-friendly, or, like, help us, like, you know, convert older buildings to be more, like, fucking garden rooftops and shit, instead of being a complete psycho about everything. It's like there's plenty of ways that they could kind of not really make them good guys, just make them, like, you know, less of a, it's Poison Ivy, she released a toxin, and she's trying to destroy the downtown with a giant fucking sunflower or some shit. You know what I mean? It's like they have the ability to do great good. It is just like, how do you keep fucking this up and dropping the ball every time you imprison them? It's like, figure out a way.
Until we know what we're dealing with out there, until we have a solid lead on Scarecrow, our priority is to dig in here and look out for our own. Any questions?
Nope, they're all chicken shit. All right. I actually really like the design of this, how it's got, like, it's just like a weird combination hodgepodge of different interior styles. Although I'm not a big fan of, like, the weird monitors everywhere thing.
Bureaucrats, we're on our own.
We can handle it, Jim. What's the latest?
We've got incidents cropping up all over the city. Cash, give us a rundown.
I thought Cash was the security guard. Prison.
First up, we've lost contact with the fire crew from Station 17. We've got their last known coordinates, but they're not going to survive out there on their own for long. Then there's this. It's a strange one. Body turned up. We didn't have long to look before the evacuation, but the forensics boys seemed freaked out. Real nasty. Also, we've had several sightings of the Riddler creeping around the train yard. Knowing that guy, he's got to be up to no good.
And it's always making trouble in our neighborhood.
You're busy, but anything you can do to help is going to save lives.
Don't worry, Jim. I have someone working a lead on Scarecrow. I'll see what I can do.
Good to hear. I've got a skeleton crew searching Gotham South and West. I'm gonna join him when I'm done here. We're gonna find that son of a bitch. Fernandez, it's Gordon. Give me an update.
Okay. I actually want to do the Riddler. Out of everything in this game, I've completed everything except Riddler's stuff. So I'd like to give it a try in this playthrough.
I'm going after Riddler.
Never good luck out there, Batman. Before.
Good luck, Batman. I love you, Batman. You snapped my arm, Batman.
God knows how we got out without shooting anyone. The people in that diner tore each other apart.
Is it just me? The toxins don't seem to be wearing off.
I hope you're wrong.
Hey, Batman! I guess Scarecrow gave you the slip. You broke my wrist for nothing! He's got plans for you, Batman. You and all your friends! Tonight's the night we finally break the bat!
Like, serious mental illness in this city. Like, fuck's sake, people. You snap my wrist, so I'm gonna keep talking shit to you. What are you gonna do? Snap the other one? Yeah.
Batman, we're not doing too good in here. Slow breath, it don't John. Look it, but we're the lucky ones.
I have to get back out there.
You're not going anywhere. You've got a concussion.
They need help.
You won't be helping anyone in your state. You'll get yourself killed.
I left them. My friends.
Listen, you did everything you could. It's not your fault.
This is such a great game, man. I just wish they put out either a Batman game or just some sort of Justice League game.
It's good to have you on board.
On the PS5. And it's like, yeah, there's Gotham Knights, but that, I'm pretty sure, was also for PS4. I'm saying, like, just straight up PS5 only. But that will take quite a few more years before anything like that will come out, if there is anything like that that's going to come out. Which sucks. I mean, I don't think I know anyone that's, like, prefers a Suicide Squad game over just wanting a Justice League game in general. It's like, bruh. Alright, let's go after Riddler and see how that's going.
Air support saw it turn into some kind of tank.
Nice.
Don't get too close. He's here. Back up.
Good evening, Mr. Wayne. I hope the car is performing to your high expectations.
Actually, Lucius, she's a little sluggish.
I had a feeling you'd say something like that. Give me a few moments, and I'll bring the afterburner function online.
Thanks, Lucius. It was good of you to stay behind.
You want to thank me, Mr. Wayne? Just try not to hurtle off the road. I should have some more upgrades ready soon.
You know, speaking of Lucius Fox, he is a part of this universe.
I have messages for you all. To the vandals who stayed behind to pick still more flesh from Gotham's bones. Have your fun. You are under my protection. To the cowards quaking behind the police department.
Why, hello there, detective. Yes, it's me, your most feared nemesis, the Riddler. Congratulations are in order, for you have arrived early for this, the next generation of my riddles. I'm afraid the full particulars of my plan will have to remain unannounced for the time being. But I see no harm in rewarding the harmless little glimmer of initiative you have shown with a sneak peek, a preview, if you will, of the kind of conundrum I have in store.
I like he's got question mark themed Hawaiian shirts. Not really.
Well then, detective, it begins. You are staring, with stupefied incomprehension, at a mechanism I have calibrated to respond to an extremely precise radar pulse. In a moment, I will give you the decrypted code, Dark Knight. Oh, but first, I think we should run through the ground rules for tonight's festivities. Rule the first. You will address me at all times as Riddler, the Riddler, or Mr. Nigma, sir. Otherwise, detective, I expect your patented brand of churlish silence. Rule the second. All gauntlets, cowl-integrated microphones, and other communications devices, bat-themed or otherwise, are to be switched off prior to the start of the test. Should you be caught using any of these, you will be expelled from the course. Rule the third. The use of purpose-built riddle-solving equipment is strictly prohibited. I am familiar with the contents of your utility belt, detective, and I will be evaluating any sudden additions over the course of this evening most suspiciously. Rule the fourth. In the event of fire or flood, I will be on hand to guide you to the nearest emergency exit. Assuming, that is, you are not too proud to follow my advice. In that eventuality, we will consider your stubbornly prideful suicide an admission of defeat. Rule the fifth. Do not ask for clues. Rule the six. Should I, in my exasperation, choose to provide you with a clue, an obliquely meaningful insult, or any other form of assistance, you will not ask for further elucidation, but instead thank me for my kind generosity whilst adhering to the forms of address outlined. What? How did you solve tonight's very first riddle? Well done.
I wonder how long he'd keep talking if you didn't do that.
You must complete 3 circuits of this gauntlet, finishing each before the time limit expires. Come now, detective. Let's put that grotesque ego-mobile to the test. Be ready, Dark Knight. There's more to this test than just going vroom, vroom, really fast. Turn around, you dark...
No! No! They start you so freaking close. Wow.
Tick-tock, detective. Tick-tock.
Yeah, we're not gonna make this.
Can that ramshackle motor handle this?
I don't know. It feels awkward, and I definitely should not be able to handle that. The course for, like, being an underground slog looks pretty great. And I do like the added component.
Faster, Dark Knight, faster! Can those flickering, faltering synapses keep up with my automatically adjusting course?
I'm disabling the afterburner's failsafe. I need the extra speed.
I'm shocked, Dark Knight. Is that really as fast as it goes? Let's work that undeveloped brain of yours.
No! Oh my god, that was so weird. The first time I did the wall, I was like really not having it. Like, as soon as you get actually up on the wall, you're good, but like when you're transferring, you can easily slide off. Yeah, I like this little like pop-out wall stuff that's happening.
Attention, detective. Go left.
Shit.
You're going backwards, Dark Knight.
That was bad. Oh my god. Alright. I'm still not super used to the driving in this.
You're close.
Oh my god. That is so... Oof. That's such a quick stop. No! I'm an idiot. I accidentally tapped it. Now, once you actually get on, like, the white...
Dark Knight, don't waste my time. It's several times more precious than yours.
I'm not gonna make it.
You appear to have been utterly...
Yeah.
...by my superiority. Try again, detective. I have all night.
I have a light. Okay. That was definitely awkward.
Would you like another attempt at that lap?
Oh wow, you could do specifically that lap? Alright.
If you can't understand the intellectual virtues of completing this trial, Batman, I'm not going to explain them to you. Aren't things clearer now that that insane clown has been disposed
of? Oh my god!
Now you know who your real nemesis is. Hurry up, detective. You stand marginally more of a chance of succeeding if you actually begin.
Here we go. I can't remember what upgrades we can get for the Batmobile.
Congratulations, detective. You have defeated me. Seriously, Dark Knight, I'm stunned, humiliated.
There's just a lot of talking in this. Like, it's insane how much VO there is. It's like everyone's constantly talking.
Did you really believe that a challenge designed by me, the Riddler, would be quite so easy? Oh, Dark Knight, you sweet, naive sentinel. Of course it wouldn't. Still, thanks to your unrelenting desire to showboat, I now have several hundred terabytes worth of performance data relating to that latest model of rocket-powered hearse you're driving. Naturally, I shall be using this data to calibrate further challenges and trials. I'll see you soon, Detective. There's a lot more to come.
Cool beans. I'm still getting used to the controls. All right.
I'm going to the train yard. Nigma's planning something. He always is.
Okay, I'm trying to think. Maybe I'll have to hold off. Oh, wait. Yeah, that's right. Damn it, I keep hitting that thinking that it's the select. Yes, alright. Alright. Do this.
The missing fire crew's not safe on these streets. I'll start by checking Dixon Duck West.
I think out of like all of the side quests, or not really side quests, all of the different quests, this one definitely feels like the most like side questy. I can't remember if this is like a Firefly situation or if this just happens to be. Damn it, I keep hitting that for reverse. Years of video game car driving has conditioned me to have that be reverse.
You think he's had enough?
You're a hero. Dang it. Why is the damn hostage always in the way? All right, there we go.
Truck was attacked. The rioters dragged us out one by one. We were separated, taken away. Please, they're gonna kill us.
I'll save your crew. Wait here. I'll get a GCPD officer to pick you up.
Whee! Okay, progress. Alfred, I need you to explain this through VO. I am 100% gonna have such issue remembering the controls in this game. All right. Well, we got that. Can we do the next one, like, right off the bat?
The rioters have taken the fire crew hostage. They'll regret it when I track them down.
Yeah, I can't remember how we track them down. Maybe it's just exploration throughout.
It's confirmed. Rioters spotted in the cauldron. Falcon 5 out.
I'm not sure how we access that. Oh yeah, I forgot we have these rubber bullets. Which can still kill people, by the way. It's actually not really as safe. I mean, you could easily take out someone's eye, or just like it could easily puncture the skin, because, you know, it's still a bullet flying at high velocity. Hey, rioters in Chinatown. All right, we got a lot going on.
Someone killed, mutilated, and posed a body on Merchant Bridge. If I'm going to stop them, I need to investigate the crime scene for clues.
I don't quite remember this storyline. I'm assuming it's either Anarchy or Hush. Because they're both kind of drama queens. Alright. Or maybe it's Zaz. But Zaz usually doesn't pose people.
Alfred, I found the mutilated body Cash was talking about. I'm going to try and establish a cause of death.
I start interrogating the dead body. Who did this? Nice. Based on the DNA sample, it was strangulation.
Blood tests reveal the cause of death was an overdose of painkillers leading to cardiac arrest. Also, the victim's fingerprints have been burned off with acid.
A rather unsavory demise.
That's not all. It's as though the subject's DNA has been corrupted somehow. There's insufficient information for me to cross-reference the database. I'll have to use the deep tissue scanner to analyze the body for distinguishing features and determine the victim's identity.
Right you are, sir.
Also be, I think Jane Doe is a character that kills people and steals their identity. Are we told?
Deformity on the left ear. Looks like a result of minor ear agenesis, a birth defect.
Good thing that we have these hyper-specific clues. And it's not, normal ears. Interesting. Anything to the kidneys? Weird shaped belly button. What are we looking at here? Is it just, okay, crime scene in general, or is it him specifically? Oh, there we go.
A wedding ring in the lower intestine. The inscription reads, Ophelia.
And then it feels like there's got to be something with the skeleton, right? I'm not seeing anything like broken or anything. Okay, I feel like I'm missing something. I'm not seeing anything really broken. Oh, right there. Kinda missed that.
The victim had a hip replacement. Scar tissue hasn't fully healed, so it must have been recent.
Alfred, the victim's name is Anthony Lund. Hospital records show he suffered with alcoholism, most probably brought on by the breakdown of his marriage. The name on the ring, Ophelia, his ex-wife. He was last seen in Albuquerque, New Mexico. What's unusual is that they didn't go missing in Gotham. They were brought here and killed. Why? We need to track down whoever did this.
Might I suggest keeping an ear out for any more of that ghastly opera music? It sounds ominously like a calling card.
Alright, what are our options? Body suits. I'm assuming there's some for, like, yeah, bullet resistance. Gotta get the bullet resistance right away, or else we're effed in the A. Alright, let's get back to the main story.
To see what Oracle's found on Scarecrow's toxin.
Let's hope it's good news, sir.
Okay, I'll do these off stream. How to do, I could have sworn there was a way to like rocket out immediately into a grapple.
Hey, I can't wait till Scarecrow releases that crap. Life was starting to get real boring around here.
I feel like the rain shader is a little strong, buddy. Classic. Oh, dude, the gray ghost!
Identity confirmed.
Or, sorry, the ghost in gray. That's a throwback to the animated series. I think it's everything waterproof in here.
Come in the Batcave, start messing with all your stuff?
You've managed to reduce the compound to its core elements.
But there's nothing in there that we can trace.
What if we'd been looking at this the wrong way? Instead of searching for the toxin, what if we focus on the manufacturing process?
Why didn't I see this? The reaction emits a unique radiation spike.
Run a scan of the city for this energy signature. It will show where Scarecrow was creating his fear toxin.
It'll take a few hours to bring the satellites into position.
We don't have enough time. I'll repurpose the antenna at the movie studios.
Bruce, I spoke to Dad. I hate lying to him. He'd kill me if he knew I was still in the city. He still blames himself for this.
We'll stop Scarecrow.
Yeah, he shouldn't have opened up the door. Shouldn't have let you open up the door. Okay. Yeah, we don't have any of our hacking tools yet. I feel like it's not even raining as bad as it is inside.
Jim, we've got a way to find out where Crane's working from.
Thank God. What can I do?
Get your men ready. Soon as we've got a location, I'll let you know.
All right.
All right.
This is more like it. Gotham went to sleep after Joker died.
I can't remember if we can get out there. I think we can. All of these different challenges. I can't remember. Is there just a city map? Yep. Okay, there we are. Are all of them just the same AR challenge? All right. Whee!
There were whispers after Arkham City. Some think you changed. Some think you killed him. I know better. I know there is a line that even the Batman fears to cross.
If I'm going to stop this killer, I should analyze the body I found on the rooftop of the Gotham Herald.
So the music is a massive clue when you're like exploring whenever you start hearing it.
All right, guys, it's party time. There won't be...
Alfred, I found another body. The mutilation pattern looks to be identical to the previous murder victim.
Then it appears Gotham does indeed have a serial killer in its midst. And here I was thinking this evening couldn't get any worse.
I'm going to scan the body for unique identifiers.
This just reminds me of the Batman movie that came out recently. Somewhat recently. I wonder who the villain for the sequel would be. I'd hope it would be someone more unusual, like Hush or even Anarchy would make a lot of sense given what happened in the first movie.
Scar tissue on the upper arm. I recognize the pattern. 20 years ago, this was a badge of honor among inmates at Blackgate Penitentiary. A small group of racketeers known as the Bloodhaven Six. Remnants of a pacemaker fitted through the right ventricle. If I cross-reference the manufacturer with the pacing method, it will help to narrow the search.
Ah, sorry, sometimes it's a little delicate. Thank God.
Clear signs of bone deformation on the victim's knee. Joint line sclerosis points to juvenile arthritis, a rare and debilitating condition. Alfred, I've ID'd the victim as Franklin Accardo.
His records are a litany of drug-related offenses, sir. In and out of prison from an early age. He was serving a 20-year sentence at Blackgate before being released early on grounds of ill health due to a heart condition. He moved to Little Rock, Arkansas, which is where he was reported missing.
Another person taken from outside the Gotham area.
A significant detail, sir.
So are these words written beside the bodies. Try and find a connection between the two victims I've found, Alfred. There has to be something linking them together.
I'll try my best, sir.
So I just came to a realization. That's why Batman constantly beats people into submission. It's like he snaps their legs and arms, so they have to get pins and shit put in it. That way, when he finds the dead body later and you can't identify it, he'll be like, oh yeah, that's that guy I snapped his arm like 6 months ago, and he had to put a pin in it. Because when shit like that happens, it's easier to identify the dead body. That man just needs to break everyone's arm. And then boom.
By the time we're finished, there's gonna be nothing left in this stinking city.
Alright. You're right, background character, number 45. Where is your tank? Which, I'm not a big fan of the whole, like...
You thought me gone, didn't you, Batman? Lost in the waters beneath Arkham. But like all submerged, forgotten fears. Eventually, I returned.
The whole, they just hire an army to basically come in. Kinda like in cities. Except this is just like a straight up military force where the first one was supposed to be like security guards.
The generator's damaged. I need to bypass it and power the antenna directly.
Hello again, Mr. Wayne. How can I help you this time?
Is the power winch ready for deployment?
It's 100% functional. Though no guarantees if you're intending to pull that car of yours up the side of a building.
You read my mind.
It's in the job description, Mr. Wayne. Batwing's on its way.
You know, since Lucius Fox is a part of this, it's a little disappointing that Batwing isn't a character in the Gotham Knights game. I know it's it's made by a different studio. But, like, you never see Batwing in anything. And I'm not talking about the, plane. I'm talking about the character. Okay, where is it supposed to be? If you don't know, Batwing is... I believe he's supposed to be Lucius Fox's son. For the most part. I think that's like what who he usually is. And it's basically like the suit from Batman Beyond, except like quote unquote present day version of it and not like the cool future version. Which I still have not looked into, like how the hell did that happen in the first place? All I know is I'm like 90% sure that Lucius's son was like part of the military, which is why he clearly doesn't need any kind of Batman training. Which I hate when they fucking do that. The reason why Batman's interesting is because he was a normal dude, kind of. He was super rich. And he went on, like, this journey learning all these different things. And then, like, most of the other people that come into it, it's like, oh, don't worry, he was part of the military before. That's why he's super good at fighting and shit. It's like, that's not how that works. And it's fucking stupid that, like... Most superheroes, or like most side characters that come into like mainline superhero comics, just skip over their whole training phase just because, well, they were a cop before. It's like, really? So that's why you're so good with hand-to-hand combat? Grappling hook! Why don't you just do a Transformers?
I'll improvise.
Yeah, why don't you just pull a Transformers and just, like, let the Batwing connect with the car and just fly it up over. Drop it.
And please be careful with the car, Mr. Wayne. She's one of a kind.
I'm well aware of that. Only took a few trillion dollars to get this sucker working. Pull. I'm an idiot. I thought I was referring to pull the car, not pull that. Well, that's a few thousand dollars worth of damage. Awesome. Good work, Batman. Don't worry. I'll spend a few billion on this car, and then I'll do a few hundred thousands, if not millions, dollars of damage. What the fuck? I love that the car is just indestructible, but what the fuck? I was going decently fast. Afterburners, that's what it is. Okay, shit. Down in the corner. Going to this mode is just makes it so much easier to, like, stop. Okay, hold for battle mode. Okay, well, what do we do here now? Oh, there we go. Heal it like a tin can. Just a fucking dead drop stop. No! Oh my god, that sucks! I was barely even going forward! Oh my god. Alright. Just go into tank mode. At this point, I just want to. No rooftop topper is gonna fuck with me. I am the knight. Oh my god, why am I so incompetent with the Batmobile? I forgot this was a thing. Oh my god. Trying to control that is not an easy thing.
Oracle,
to the radio antenna.
Great. I'm connecting now. I was just talking to Robin. I think you should too.
Bruce, you need me out there. We can find Scarecrow faster together.
What you're working on is more important, Tim.
Can wait one night. Let me help.
I've got this under control.
Okay. Listen, try checking in once in a while. We're partners, remember?
He just wants to help, you know.
Is the antenna ready?
Yeah, but we're going to need a microwave tower to triangulate Scarecrow's location. There's one at Falcone's shipping in the cauldron. I've marked it on your map.
Thanks, Oracle.
And yeah, they totally wasted a perfectly good opportunity to incorporate Robin into this game.
The Batmobile's powering the antenna. I can't use it right now.
Oh no.
Give up the hunt, Bat.
I'm Bat.
You won't find me until I want you to.
Scarecrow's men are guarding the antenna. I need to evaluate the threat and plan my attack.
If that happens, this whole operation falls apart. What do we need him for?
Five soldiers, all armed. If I alert them, they'll kill the hostage and need to reach a vantage point to draw them outside.
If you ask me, he's paranoid. Probably huffing too much of that gas. Do you say that to his face?
You kidding me? I can't even look at the guy.
If I can separate them, they'll be easier to take down.
Hey, you hear that? Someone's out there. You two, go take a look. The door stays locked. I'm taking no chances. Got it, boss.
Batmobile's powering the antenna. I can't use it right now.
You're gonna have to sleep it off.
Three more soldiers inside. They think they're safe if they stick together. Lucius, I've got a hostage situation. Three gunmen. I need to take them all out before they can react. Is it ready?
Flexible plates over an MR fluid armor layer. You'll move faster, hit harder, and look scarier while doing so.
Send it, Lucius, now.
Already airborne, Mr. Wayne.
Scarecrow's men still have a hostage at the antenna. I should head back there before they do something they'll regret.
Okay, I was sitting waiting for it to get dropped. And I don't know how I feel about the Batsuit being super high tech if it's not like Batman Beyond. I kind of just like the basic Batman, like, okay, it's like strong against like bullets and like knife attacks. I don't like it being all like Iron Man-esque where it's like armor plated and stuff. Unless it's like a specific themed like run. Where it's like Batman went back in time during King Arthur's times. Which there's actually quite a few comics like that. But none of them are actually like full runs. They're always like one-offs. Which would be cool if they did a run like that. In fact, they just did an insane run. I think it was last year. Where it's just the DC universe, except if everyone were like humanoid dinosaur people. It's like, oh, that's sick.
Inner layers of the bodysuit are made of a titanium dip tri-weave. It's between those layers where things get interesting. Wayne Tech MR fluid hardens in response to impact. With this kind of shock absorption, you'll be able to put more force into your counterattacks. The liquid armor is more flexible than the fibers you're accustomed to as well. You can use that increased maneuverability to take out multiple foes in quick succession. The suit's compatible with the Batmobile's electromagnetic eject mechanism, too. You'll fly out of that thing like a bullet from a railgun.
Awesome.
Speaking of which, the new grapnel launcher will pull you skyward just as fast. Don't worry, Mr. Wayne. That suit can take the G's.
Not really the suit that's the problem, it's the person inside.
I've activated the AR training program should you want to run diagnostics, or just break it in.
We're in the middle of a thing right now, guy, so I don't know if that's really the best thing. Do we have just normal combat?
Simulation activated. Ish.
I forgot they introduced that. Probably shouldn't be doing this during, like, you know, an active hostage situation, but we need to learn how to take down people with guns. Where are you grappling to? How did he not see me? Yeah, that was sloppy and bad. I thought it was gonna be more specific on taking down gunmen, not just like, here's a takedown situation. Yeah, let's just do all these, get it out of the way.
Simulation activated.
Nope, I missed one.
Simulation failed. Simulation
I missed that one. I thought that one was more vertical.
Simulation
Wait, well, hold on. Grapple, boost, glide, dive without touching the ground. Like, I literally just did that. Like, you just told, like, I just did the thing you told me to do. And I did it successfully two different times. Maybe I have to glide longer in between. Come on, where the f- It would help if there was a grapple nearby. Oh, to the Wayne Tech upgrade point. Well, where the fuck is that? Wait, it says the Wayne Tech upgrade point. There's nothing marked as that. Hold on. Or wait, is it to get a Wayne Tech upgrade point? Or... Ugh, this is fucking stupid. Holy shit. Okay, dive, yes. Let go, yes. I completely fucked that up. Why can't I grapple onto these fucking bridges? Why are these bridges like a complete dead zone on being able to grapple to? I do not understand that. Okay. What in the fuck is going on with this? It's just a basic grapple, glide, dive, and then like come back from it. Like, I'm not understanding why this is not working. This is fucking weird. Okay, there. Burn it. Okay. There. I did it. Now, don't tell me it's something fucking stupid where it's like, okay, cool, you did it. Now run out the clock. Is that what it is? Is it like literally part of the time? Without touching the ground within 60 seconds. That's what it is. I misunderstood. I thought they meant to do those maneuvers again within the next 60 seconds. Not do those maneuvers to keep you from touching the ground for the next 60 seconds. Got it. That's... Okay, I feel like they could word that a little bit better. Without touching the ground. 60 seconds.
Simulation complete.
Or 60 seconds. Okay, yeah, alright. Never mind, that does make sense. I was being an idiot. I was too focused on, like, keeping myself up in the air and not fucking that over than focusing on what it was saying. Hey, caramba. Alberto.
Simulation activated.
Okay. This is one of the sickest ways to get into a car ever, though, to be fair. That's what it was.
Simulation failed.
Wait, what? I double tapped, he launched up and then dropped back down. All right. Oh, damn it. Last time I played this, it was on the PS4. I honestly don't even remember what the load times for this stuff was.
Simulation activated.
Oh, holy shit. Time is flying by. I thought we were still, like, within the first hour. We are not. This, I remember this. This part was awesome. Being able to, like, rocket out of it and stuff. The Batmobile is fun, but it's like they just go a little too ham on it. And honestly, I think if these games were, like, a little more simplified, and it's just like, here's a detective thing, we need to solve this mystery, I think it'd be cool. Which, by the way, apparently they're... I don't know if they just released it or if it's about to be released, but there's Murder on the Orient Express, the game, where it's like, how the fuck do you make that into a game? Like, that's one of the problems with murder mysteries, where it's like, once you get the ending, it's like, okay, that's it. Like, it's like watching a movie. It's like, you just need to do it one time and that's it. Most games give you, like, a lot more extra stuff where it's like, okay, well, you could do these side quests or, like, here's a different way to play the game, where it's like, a story, like a narrative-based game, is just like one and done. A lot of the times, if they don't give you like multiple endings, where it's like, what would be the multiple ending for that? Like, maybe two or three endings? But it's just like, bro. I don't know how the Sherlock Holmes games work. I'm assuming it's basically just Batman's Detective Vision, the game. Okay, move close. It's the fear multi-takedown. Okay, well, you're not really telling us how to do it. Cool, you're just saying use the fear multi-takedown. Okay, how do you use the fear multi-takedown? Like, that you're not telling us the buttons or anything. You're just telling us to take them down. Wow, we were like all up on them. Okay. How do you use fear? Like, I'm not understanding. Oh, there we go. Oh, okay. So it's a thing that, like, pops up at last second. There we go.
Simulation activated.
I wish there was a tag or something where it's like, use the fear multi-takedown. Use the fear multi-takedown. Get close and hit this. Nope. Dang it. For him to look away. And I forgot this was a thing. But for just like a quick multi-takedown. Great. Oh wow, that was a lot lower. I do like you have to have, like, the camera pointed towards the enemy that you want to take down. Nope. Hello? Hello? Oh. Fuck, he was in the camera, but he has to be, like, more centered, I guess?
Simulation. Oh.
I think I have to do it from a crouched position. There we go. Okay, yeah, it was weird when I took down that center one and I tried to turn to take out the guy to my side. Like, he was within camera, but he wasn't being, like, being able to be selected. Alright, there we go. That took us longer than it should have. Mainly because that shitty gliding one. Alright, upgrades. Gotta get the resistant armor stuff so we can survive and we don't end up taking L's when we really don't need to.
Three gunmen, one hostage. Time to put this suit to the test.
And by the way, learning that fear takedown is like a must for this.
The Batmobile's powering the antenna. I can't use it right now.
Hey, how the fuck do I... Great entry, alright.
The new suit is faster and more mobile. By getting...
Actually, it might be easier just to do this first and then do those. That way you know what the fear takedown is. Okay. There we go.
Man, they said you were quick, but I never saw anyone take down three-armed guys like that. Unbelievable.
You're safe now. I'll send someone to pick you up.
Thank you. Tell me you're gonna find Scarecrow. That son of a bitch needs to be stopped.
Don't worry, they all have skull fractures now, and possibly one of them has a brain bleed. So swift.
Not yet. I need to access the console. Oracle, I've attached the uplink to the microwave tower.
Perfect. I made an anonymous call to GCPD. They're gonna send someone to pick up the hostage. Come on, connect. Love the suit, by the way. Okay, both towers are fully online.
Time to find Scarecrow. I need to use both antennas to identify the micro and radio wave frequencies across Gotham. If I can find both frequencies at the same location, I'll know where Scarecrow is manufacturing his toxin. Radio and microwave frequencies point to Ace Chemicals. That's where Scarecrow's producing the toxin.
To be fair, when is it not Ace Chemicals? And I love Ace Chemicals, it's just like...
Ace Chemicals. That's where we'll find Scarecrow.
Impossible. I've had a team there ever since the evacuation started, just like you asked.
Crane must have bought them off. Or worse.
I'm in the area. I'll round up my guys and head over.
Hold off until I get there, Jim. I'm on my way.
Yeah, it's always Ace Chemicals, man. It's like, where could it be? It's Ace Chemicals. It's always Ace Chemicals. It's either stolen from Wayne Tech or it's stolen from Ace Chemicals.
Control, we've got a situation
rioters think they can hold the fire crew hostage. I'll make them sorry.
That was very not smooth. Line kick. Oh, there's actually more. All right. Full force, like, did a jumping punch right to his dick. Ouch.
Your allies won't help you.
The fire crew. Their lives are in danger. No time to lose.
Like, it said there was one over near this bridge, but it's like not coming up. Sick that you do have like a car call button. Like, what the heck? That helicopter was like saying that there was one of the firefighters in need over here. Like, I'm not seeing it anywhere. Like the architecture and all that of this. Okay, so 3 seems to be the limit. It's the last time I'm volunteering for this shit.
Thank you. I thought I was dead for sure. Those animals.
Think. What do you remember about the attack?
The chief had us heading back into the city, searching for civilians. He said we weren't leaving anyone behind, and then from nowhere, this fireball or something slammed into us. I must have blacked out. Next thing I know, one of these psychos is stubbing a cigarette out on me. You found the others? What about the chief?
I'm still looking. Wait here. I'll arrange for you to be taken to safety.
Yeah, the firefighter mission does not feel like it jives with all the rest of the quests that we're doing. I don't know, it feels like it should be in its own, like, small, like side category. Oh shit, I forgot I could take weapons.
Have some fun with you, Batman.
I can't remember if there's XP for like actually just fighting people. I don't think there is. I haven't been paying super close attention to it. Oh no, there's XP. I mean, come on, they set this up to be like the long Halloween. And then they just do Red Hood's story. Which it's just like, then why set up the long Halloween stuff, kind of? It could have just been a normal day and then Red Hood shit. Because here's the thing.
I thought Arkham City was fun, but this is another level.
If you set it up to be like Halloween, then it's like, okay, you're expecting the long Halloween story. But then when you set it up and then you don't do it, it's just like, oh, you're wasting an opportunity, man.
The bat's been in control for too long. It's about time we put tables on that freak.
I think I'm going to call it here for today before we go in over there. If I remember correctly, that is actually like a whole thing where we have to make our way through Ace Chemicals, I think. I can't remember if it's Ace Chemicals or if it's like, I think we go to one of the prisons. I can't remember which one. Is kind of lengthy, so I don't want to do that. Like, get started on that and then just end it in the middle of it. So we're gonna end for today our first day back into the Batman universe. And yeah, right now the plan is to play this, and then once we finish this up, we're going to hop into Gotham Knights. I don't know if we're gonna take a break in between. We'll see when we get there, but yeah. That is it for today, guys. Thank you for coming out and hanging out on day 1,104 of streaming in a row. And yeah, I'm that's it. God. Like always, links down below for my Twitter, as well as links over to my YouTube channel where all my previous streams are uploaded and archived over there. And I'll catch you all tomorrow, where we'll be continuing some more Tears of the Kingdom, which I've really been enjoying. And then on Tuesday, we're going to be getting back into Genshin Impact, continuing with the main story. Then, yeah, next weekend will be the next time we play some more Batman Arkham Knight. That is it for now. I will catch you all later.